Welcome all of you to the new spectroscopy, that is IR spectroscopy. This is a very important spectroscopy for determining the functional groups present in the organic compounds and inorganic compounds. So IR spectroscopy gives us the clear cut the what are the types of the functional groups present in our compound, that is carbonyl compound, aldehyde group or acidic group, ester group, any type of functional group can be detected in the IR spectroscopy. So this is very very important spectroscopy. That's why everyone has the must have the knowledge about the IR spectroscope. Now we know about the electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic spectrum consists of these types of the regions, that is the cosmic rays, X-rays, ultraviolet and microwave, and these are the some of the wavelengths which are shown here. IR, sunlight, infrared light, IR regions. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 types of the IR regions. That is near IR, that is called the overtone regions, having the wavelength 0.8 to 2.5 micrometer and wave number is 12,500 to 4,000 per centimeter. Mid IR regions, that is also called the vibrational rotational region. This region is very important, having the wavelength 2.5 to 50 micrometer and having the wave number 4,000 to 200. The far IR, that is called the rotational region, having the wavelength 50 to 1,000 micrometer and having the wave number 200 to 10 per centimeter. The most used are 2.5 to 50, means rotational vibrational region. Then principles of the IR spectroscopy. When IR light is passed through the sample of the organic compound, some of the frequencies are absorbed while others are transmitted. When we plot of absorbance versus transmittance versus wave number gives the IR spectrum, but conveniently wave number versus percentage of transmittance is plotted. Then we know about the IR spectrum of the benzoic acid. Here we can see the IR spectrum of the benzoic acid is having COH as a functional group, that is acidic functional group. In that we can see the OH group is also there and carbonyl group is also there. This OH group shows the peak here. This is the OH group in the COH group. And this is the carbonyl group functions. Means carbonyl group function is above 1600 per centimeter and this one is up to 32,000 per centimeter. Then we can see the requirement of the IR radiation absorption, the correct wavelength of radiation. If a molecule absorbs the radiation only when natural frequency of vibration of some part of molecule is same as frequency of the incident light. Requirement. Then second is requirement of IR radiation absorption. Electric dipole. The molecule must have the electric dipole, means it must have the positive and the negative pole. Positive pole for H plus and Cl minus for the negative pole. If a frequency of vibration of HCl molecule exactly matches with the coming from the sources, net transfer of energy takes place. The change in amplitude of molecular vibration gives the absorption of radiation. In case of O2, N2, Cl2, no net change in the dipole moment occurs. Thus, they cannot absorb IR radiation and do not show the IR spectra. Two types of changes occur in the molecule. That is the molecular rotational and molecular vibration. Molecular rotational transitions are of little use to the spectroscopist. Rotational transition are not that much, but vibration are very important. The position of atoms in a molecule are not fixed. They are subject to a number of different vibrations. There are types of molecular vibration, that is stretching. Stretching means stretching is of two types, symmetric stretching and asymmetric stretching. Symmetric stretching means these two atoms at one time goes away from the central atom or comes toward the central atom. Means these two atoms have the same activity, either they goes away from the main central atom or come toward the central metal atom, then at that time we can call it as a symmetric stretching. Asymmetric stretching means these two bonded atoms have the different behavior. Here we can see the one atom is approaches toward the central atom and another atom goes away from the central atom, means these two atoms behavior is different. So that is called the asymmetric stretching. Then types of molecular vibrations. The molecular vibrations is of bending. Bending vibration is of four types. In bending vibration, there is change in between the two bonds. There are four types of the bending vibration, that is scissoring, rocking, twisting and the wagging. Rocking, scissoring, twisting and wagging. In plane, there are two types of bending vibration. In the plane, these two types of vibration, and out of plane, these two types of the vibrations. In the plane means these two atoms move above the plane or below the plane at one time. This is also like scissor. When the two atoms approaches each other, then it is called the scissoring type of vibration. Then another two types of vibrations is out of plane wagging vibrations. The first one is wagging, means first comes nearer to each other, and in the twisting type of vibrations, one is nearer to us and another is far from us. That is called the twisting vibrations. Carbon dioxide can vibrate in the following ways. Means carbon dioxide atoms may vibrate in symmetric stretching or symmetric stretching and in the bending as shown in the figure. Below is the infrared spectrum of the ethanol with some identified fingerprints. Ethanol is having the OH bond, means its ethanol is having the primary alcohol, that shows the OH stretching in a broad peak. And here we can see the CH bonds. Here is the CO bond, that is up to 1200 per centimeter. Here we can see the structure of ethanol. Then vibrational frequency. A molecular vibration occurs when atoms in a molecule are in a periodic motion, while the molecule as a whole has a constant transitional and rotational motion. The frequency of periodic motion is known as the vibrational frequency. Factors affecting upon the vibrational frequency: the vibrational coupling, hydrogen bonding, electronic effect, field effects, nature of solvent will be there. The potential energy diagram of oscillator. This is the potential energy diagram of the oscillator. Internuclear distance is Re. Simple harmonic motion. This is the type of periodic motion where the restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement. Unharmonicity is the deviation of a system from being a harmonic oscillator, an oscillator that is not oscillating in the simple harmonic motion. Vibrational modes, that is the normal mode of an oscillating system, is the pattern of motion in which all parts of the system moves sinusoidally with the same frequency. Combination bands are observed when more than two or more fundamental vibrations are excited simultaneously. These vibration modes arise from the unharmonicity of the oscillators, which leads to an interaction of the vibrational states in polyatomic molecule. Vibrational modes, that is the overtone, the results from the excitation from ground state to the higher energy states. Overtone occurs when a vibrational mode is excited from V is equal to 0 to V is equal to 2, which is called the first overtone, or V is equal to 0 to V is equal to 3. This is called the second overtone. Here we can see the third and the fourth overtone when it shifts from 0 to 4th level or 0 to 5th level. The instrumentation require the following compartments, that is IR, radiation source, wavelength selection, that is monochromatic wavelength, then sample holder of the cell, then detector and the recorder. This is the main compartments of the IR spectrometer. The sources of light, that is inner solids, heated electrically to a temperature of 1500 to 2000 Kelvin. Nursed glower consists of cylinder of rare earth oxides. This is the source of the IR radiation. There are platinum discs. They are heated to a temperature 1200 to 2200 Kelvin. Nursed glower. These are the sources of the IR light. There is a glower sole similar to the nurse glower. It is also made up of the cylinder. This we can see the picture of this. To avoid excessive heating, water cooling is necessary. A high temperature source emits the IR radiation. Incandescent wire source or nichrome wire. These are the wires which we are able to use. Mercury arc is also used. Tungsten filament is very useful and widely used. Wavelength selector. Output from a wavelength selector is a band of wavelengths, that is filter, monochromator, entrance slit, collimating lens or the mirror, dispersion element or prism, focusing lens or the mirror, then exit light. Now the difference between the monochromator and the filter. This is not that much. Filters are very simple. They are sheets of plastic or glass that simply absorb the wavelength and then those required for the analysis. Monochromatic is far more complicated and comprises a series of optics inside the light proof box, which has the entry and exit slits which show the radiation of all wavelengths. Prism. The white light pass through a piece of glass and be divided into the rainbow spectrum. The problems with the prism include the relatively the poor outputs. Here we can see the prism. Then typical prism monochromator. In the diagram we can see the entrance slit, collimating lens, prism, focusing lens and exit slit. The entrance slit allows source radiation to illuminate the first lens. Gratings. It is a device which consists of series of parallel and closely spaced glows, rules of glass or the reacting surfaces. The diffraction gratings. Normal is dashed line and order 0, order 1st, order 1, order 2, order 3 are shown in the collimating mirror M1 and collimating mirror M2 in the figure. We can see here the entrance slit. The prism versus the diffraction grating. High degree dispersion, UV, IR and the visible. The multiple spectra, 0 order maximum, no deflection. Handling of sample in the IR. The sampling technique in IR depends on whether the sample is as a gas, liquid or solid. For solid, KBR disc is used. For liquid, thin film is used. And for the gas, gas cell is used. The gases may be of infrared transparent windows allow the cell to mount it directly. Internal mirrors are used which permit the beam to be reflected several times through the sample to increase the sensitivity. In vapor phase, rotational changes in the molecule occurs freely and these low frequency processes can modulate the higher energy vibrational bands. Liquids. It consists of the sampling liquid is a thin film squeezed between the two infrared transparent windows like NaCl flares. The salt flares are rock salt flares must be optically polished and cleaned immediately after the use. Toluene, chloroform, etc. are used to clean them. They should be dry and handled only by their edge. Liquid. The thickness of the film can be adjusted by varying the pressure used to squeeze the flat together. It consists of the two windows of pressed the salt, sealed and separated by thin gaskets of Teflon, copper or lead that have been wetted with mercury. The windows are usually made of sodium chloride, potassium chloride or cesium bromide. There are two cells, first cell containing sample and second one containing the pure solvent placed in infrared beam. By the reference beam, solvent absorption are cancelled out and spectrum recorded is that of the solute one. The solids are KBR discs. It is prepared by grinding the sample with KBR and compressing the hole into the transparent water of the disc. The KBR must be the dry and hence gliding is carried out under the infrared lamp. The grinding is done in a azed mortar paste. Commercial ball mills poorly ground mixture lead to the disc. The particle size 2 micrometer must be achieved to avoid the scattering. Hydraulic pressure is generated by this instrument. The compression of a cohesive disc requires high pressure. Special die are used from which air can be evacuated by hydraulic compression. The disc thus formed are easy to handle. Solids, that is moulds. The pastes prepared by grinding the sample with a drop of oil. The mould is squeezed between the transparent windows as for this liquid sampling. The liquid paraffin nozzle oil is also used in solids. Film, solid films can be deposited into the initial plates by allowing a solution in a volatile solvent to evaporate drop by drop on the surface of the plate. Polymers and various waxy. The IR detectors are the thermocouples, bolometer, Golay cell, pyroelectric detector, photoconducting detectors. The thermocouple is consist of a pair of junction formed when the two ends of a metal such as bismuth and antimony are fused to either ends of the dissimilar metal wires. Heating capacity of the absorbing element is small as they detect the change in temperature. The potential varies in the two junction with the difference in temperature. Thermocouple. One junction is cold junction, which is reference junction kept at a constant temperature, not exposed to the IR radiation. The other junction is hot junction exposed to the IR radiation, which increases the temperature junction. The temperature difference due to falling IR radiation generates the potential difference, which amounts to the IR radiation biometer. It is a type of resistance thermometer conducted from strips of metal such as platinum or nickel or from semiconductors. They show relatively the large change in the resistance as a function. It forms one of the arm of the Wheatstone's bridge. The bolometer is high radiation force. The bridge becomes unbalanced due to the change in the resistance. This causes the current to flow. The Golay cell. These are sensitive gas thermometers. The xenon gas is contained in the small membrane of one of the side, while other side has a flexible. A beam of light is reflected from the silver surface to the cathode at the vacuum. The Golay cell. When the IR radiation falls on the blanked member, it is heated, which in turn heats the xenon gas by the conductance resulting. As a result of fraction of reflection light which strike the active surface of the photo cube, it changed, leading to the change in the photocurrent. This is related to the falling the IR radiation. The pyroelectric detector. These are the constructed from the single electrode water of the pyroelectric material, which are dielectric materials which live special thermal and electrical properties. Yug detected triglycerine sulfate. When an electric field is applied across any dielectric material, dielectric polarization takes place. The magnitude of polarization is a function of dielectric constant of the material. The spiroelectric crystal is sandwiched between the two electrodes, which are higher than one.
Photoelectric detectors. The photoelectric crystals act as a temperature dependent capacitor. When ion radiation falls, there is a change in temperature which alters the charge distribution across the crystal, which can be detected as a current in the external circuit connecting to two sides of the capacitor. The magnitude of current is directly proportional to the surface area of the crystal and rate of change of polarization of the temperature. Photoconducting detector. They consist of thin film of semiconductor material such as lead sulfate, mercury cadmium telluride or indium antimony deposited on a non-conducting glassy surface and sealed into the evacuated developed to semiconductor from the atmosphere. Photoconducting detectors. Absorption of radiation by these materials promotes non-conducting valence electrons to a higher energy conducting state, thus decreasing the electric resistance of the semiconductor. The conventional IR spectroscope is looking like this: dispersion or non-dispersive, frequency domain spectra, time domain spectra, high signal to the noise radio. The FTIR sample diagram is here. We can see the diagram of the FTIR. The wave first, then wave second. Combination gives constructive interference. The wave first, wave second gives the destructive interference. The sample analysis process. The source, interometer, the sample, the detector, the computer. By double beam infrared spectrometer. Here we can see the double beam infrared spectrometer, source of radiation, infrared spectrophotometer. Here is the diagram of the infrared spectrophotometer. In the diagram we can see here the identification, test purity, structural investigation, polymorphism, pseudo polymorphism, interaction drugs, experience, patents of antibiotics, quantitative measurements, applications of the IR spectroscopy, identification of the functional group and the structural elucidation. The entire IR region is divided into the group frequency region, means functional group region, and fingerprint region. The range of group frequency, that is functional group region, is 4000 to 1500 per centimeter, while that of fingerprint region is 1500 to 400 per centimeter. In a group frequency region or functional group region, the peaks correspond to the different functional groups can be observed. According to the corresponding peaks, functional group can be determined. Each atom of a molecule is connected by a bond, and each bond requires a different IR region, so characteristic peaks are observed. This region of IR spectrum is cancelled as a fingerprint region of the molecule. It can be determined by the characteristic peaks. Using the fingerprint region, compare the IR spectra of propanol and 2-propanol. 1-propanol and 2-propanol. Both compounds contain exactly the same bonds and the same functional group and same number of the atom. Both compounds have the very similar troughs in the area sound 3000 per centimeter, but compare with the fingerprint region. This fingerprint region for primary alcohol and secondary alcohol is the different one. By that fingerprint region, we can analyze there are some of the functional groups absorption peaks. When alkylic CH group is present, then its value is below 3000, means in between the 2950 to 2850 per centimeter. When alkene or double bond is present, then its IR value is 1680 per centimeter. When alkene CH stretching, means double bond attached to the CH group, that CH group shows the frequency at 3100 per centimeter. When aromatic CH group is present, when the hydrogen atom present on the benzene ring, then it goes value above 3000. Aromatic CH bending vibration comes in between the 860 to 680. Aromatic carbon-carbon double bonds show the values in between 1700 to 1600. The phenolic OH group stays in between the 3500 to 3200 per centimeter. Carboxylic acid OH stretching bands shows somewhat the lesser value, that is in between the 2500 to 3000. The amine NH bond shows the value 3500 to 3300. The nitrile C double bond and stretching vibration shows the value in between 2260 to 2220 per centimeter. When aldehyde carbon group is present, then its value is in between the 1740 to 1690 per centimeter. When ketonic group is present, then its value is more, that is 1750 to 1680. When ester group is present, then its carbon frequency value is 1750 to 1735. And when ester carboxylic group is present, for amide group this is the value 1690 to 1630. When amide NH bond stretching is present, then it shows a higher value than the OH, that is 3700 to 3500. Then ketones, here is the IR spectrum of the ketone, means 2-butanone having carbonyl C double bond O group shows the value of 1750. This value indicates that there is ketonic group is present. These two CH stretching vibration shows here peak for the CH bonds. Amines. Amines are behave like that of the OH group. Here we can see the NH2 group peak here in between 3360 to 34 and 42 per centimeter. The alcohols is the most important because all alcohols are showing the OH peak at exactly the same, but they can be differentiated primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. When there is primary alcohol, then CO stretching bending vibration is in between the 1050. For secondary alcohol it is 1100 per centimeter, and for tertiary alcohol it is 1150 per centimeter for the tertiary alcohol, by which we can distinguish the primary, secondary and the tertiary alcohol. The applications of the IR spectroscopy. Second application is the identification of the substance. The IR spectroscopy is used to establish whether a given sample of organic substance is identical with the other or not. This is because the large number of absorption bands is observed in the IR spectra of organic molecules, and the probability that two compounds will produce the identical spectra of almost zero. So if the two compounds have the identical IR spectra, then both of them must be the sample of the same substance. The third application is the studying the progress of the reaction. The progress of the chemical reaction can be determined by the examining the small portion of the reaction mixture withdrawal from time to time, means reaction is monitored by using the IR spectrum. When the desired functional group gives the higher intensity, then we can say that the desired compound is completed. The rate of disappearance of characteristic absorption band means reactant functional group disappears and product functional groups appears. From that we can say that the reaction is completed or not. The fourth application is the detection of the impurities. The IR spectrum of the test sample is to be determined is compared with the standard compound. If any additional peak are observed in the IR spectrum, then it is due to the impurities present in the compounds. Means we can compare the two peaks. From that we can say that this one is the pure and this is impure. The fourth application is quantitative analysis. This quantity of the substance can be determined either in a pure form or as a mixture of the two or more compounds. In these characteristics peaks corresponding to the drug substance is chosen, and the log 10 per liter of peaks for standard and test sample is compared. This is called the Lyons technique, is to be determined by quantity of the substance. Disadvantages of the IR spectroscopy: non-adherence of Beer's law, and second is the complexity of the spectra. The spectra is very complex because its range is very higher. So thank you very much for kind of attention. I hope that you all of know the IR spectroscopy very much. Thank you, all of you.